Hi everyone, my name is Andreas Jung and today I would like to talk about how to make a map in QGIS using point data. I thought we'd use this data here, which is available online. I'll leave the link in the description below. It's a paper about the Nubian sandstone aquifer in the Kharga Oasis of Egypt, and they have made some very pretty maps. You can see all these points here are water wells, which were drilled into the Nubian sandstone aquifer. The location is the western desert of Egypt in the Kharga Oasis where I used to work. So hi to all my friends in Egypt. And this is a picture of some of the wells. You can see that they go down to several hundred meters and there are at least three layers in the Nubian sandstone aquifer. Now in this paper they do a lot of statistics, which you might have a look at later, but basically, what I'd like to do is produce a map a bit like this one. So the first thing we need to do is to find the data. And like any good paper, here is all the data available to us, so we can try to reproduce their results. So what we'll do is, I'm going to select all of this data here. Control-C, I go into Excel, Control V, and what's very important when we copy paste is that we check our last data row, which ends with 73, and the first one here, which starts with 1, El Sherka, and so on. So let's have a look. Yes, we have well 46, 73, and here at the top 1, El Sherka, which means that I think the block of data has copied across quite well, but there is a problem with the headers. So what we'd like to have is well location, latitude, longitude, and we can just Control X, Control C, V, sorry, paste them across, and then we need to fill in these as well, which is the well depth, H, which is the depth to static water level, pumping rate Q, drawdown after 1 minute, maximum drawdown, and transmissivity. Okay, so where I'm going to do this, I'm just going to copy this and do a paste special, transpose, and it's come across quite nicely. What is missing are the units. Okay, so maybe if we just copy this one, Control C, and I'm going to add it here. Okay, let's just check if that looks good. Yes. Now, I'm going to delete these bunch of rows up here. And actually, we also don't need this one. Now, our data table is ready. But before we begin, I'm going to format it. Go to Home and Format as Table. I'm going to choose the blue one. My table has headers, okay. If we go to table design, we can unclick the filter button, so we don't want the table to be rearranged. Okay, so now our data is in a data table. If we go to formulas, name manager, we can see that it's been called table one. I'm going to call it data, rename it as data, just to be consistent. So I'd like to clean up this table a little bit. Let's center these. If we select the whole table and we double click like this, it's going to rearrange itself in a nice way. And let's have a look at the data. You'll notice that there's some strange symbols in here. They're called hyphens. And I think what we'll do is we'll just get rid of them. Home, find and replace the hyphen with nothing. Replace all. It's made three replacements. Close. Now the reason we don't want to have the hyphens in here is because we don't want to mix numbers with text. If we read this data into QGIS, and we have both text and numbers in our data column, then QGIS will assume it's all text. So that means it won't be possible to do any statistics on this data later on. Okay, it's looking good. Let's move on to the next step. Okay, we've opened QGIS. I have the spreadsheet here on the desktop. All we need to do is grab the spreadsheet, drag it across and release it into QGIS. It opens itself automatically. We don't need to go down the CSV route here. So now what we do is we open the attribute table, have a look at the data. It's looking nice. Well, the wells maybe are not correctly in sequence, but I fixed that. The one thing I'm looking out for here is that all the numbers have to be aligned on the right side of the columns, and all the text should be aligned on the left. Previously, we removed some hyphens from the static water levels, which is now shown as a null because there's nothing in here. If we'd left them in, then this column would align itself on the left, which means it's a text, and that's not good for later statistics. Okay, another way to check if the data is okay is to look at the properties and fields, and there you can see the type of data that it has been loaded as. So real data means with decimal places, integers are whole numbers, and a string is the text. So everything's looking good. I want to convert these into points and put them on the map. So how do we do that? Open the processing toolbox, type in points, and the one we want is create points layer from table. So double click on that. It's already automatically loaded our table. The X field will be the longitude, the Y field will be the latitude, and the CRS is WGS84, that's okay. We're going to create a temporary file just in case it's not okay. Let's run it. It has completed. And here are our data points. What we need to do now is to add some background. I'm going to select the Google Satellite Hybrid. And what we'll do is put that underneath our points. Okay, the next thing we need to do is to make a bit of more space for ourselves so we can have a better idea of what's going on. I don't like the symbols very much because I can't see it very well on the satellite image. So let's change the symbology. Maybe we can use a bright red. Let's see what that looks like. I'd like to add some labels as well. So we use single labels and we'll select the well number, apply. I can't read those numbers really well, so under buffer, we're going to draw a buffer of 1 millimeter, say apply, that's already better. Let's also put it a little bit away from our symbols. 1 millimeter is usually enough. Not bad. In the maps that we saw previously, there was a little W in front of the well name. So let's add that as well. It's very simple. We write the W and we add the string concatenation. Check that the output looks okay, that's W1 there, that's fine. Apply. Okay, so we've got our points inside a map in QGIS. Don't forget that this is still a temporary file, so we're going to export it to a GeoPackage in our GeoPackage folder, and I'm going to call it Kharga Oasis, save it. Okay, it has exported successfully. Now all the symbology we've just created, let's copy it through styles, copy style, all style categories, go up here, styles, paste style, all style categories, and then all we do is remove our temporary layer and check in the properties that the style is saved as a default in the database source, so that every time we open this wells, they will already have the correct symbology and labels. Okay, so that's the end of this little video. I hope that you've enjoyed watching it with me and that you've learned something useful, and see you in the next video when we'll be looking at some of the data that's associated with these water wells in the Kharga Oasis. Thank you very much for your attention.